3-in-1 machine seems like a good idea, right? But can they actually work in a shop like yours or mine? Well, in this video, I'm going to dive into the world of furniture prototyping and manufacturing using this Snapmaker Artisan. It's a 3-in-1 machine that can 3D print, laser engrave and cut, and also mill.
I'm going to be putting this machine to the test. Are the features of this machine just gimmicks? Or are they professional tools that can really perform at production levels that both you and I require? If that's something you're interested in finding out, join me on my journey as I use this 3-in-1 by Snapmaker to transform a childhood animal stool into a modern, sleek design that ships flat and provides customers an assembly experience that will have them asking for more. Let's get started.
Like all great projects, they begin with an idea or a sketch. For me, the inspiration came from an animal stool that I had as a child. Now, putting nostalgia aside, I wanted to give this stool a more modern aesthetic and sleek design that could actually ship flat to minimize shipping costs. See, I wanted to create a structure without glue or complex assembly instructions. So after brainstorming some ideas, I designed a fastener mechanism for the legs and the tail of the stool that could be 3D printed and could be easily installed with standard wood screws. After I had finalized my design, I used the Snapmaker's Lubin Slicer software, and then I sent it over to the 3D printer to be printed. About 30 minutes later, my print was complete. The leg fastener print turned out perfectly, just how I had imagined it. The next obstacle that I faced was creating the animal-shaped stool. The stool consisted of a head, feet, body, and tail. Now, each part needed to be accurately cut, not just once, but repeatedly, as I plan to create several stools to sell on my Etsy shop and website. To solve this problem, I decided to put the Snapmaker 40-watt laser module to the test. I chose to make a pattern template for my router. I selected 1/4-inch MDF because it has a smooth surface and is very workable. However, cutting through it would test the laser's limits. This raised an important question. Can the laser handle the task of cutting this thick material successfully? I started by experimenting with the MDF by making a few test cuts. I made a few adjustments to the power and speed settings. I'm not gonna lie, it was a meticulous process. However, after some time, I did find the perfect setting to cut 1/4-inch MDF, and I'll place the setting I used in the description below. Once I had my laser dialed in, I selected my file and clicked that start button. As the laser traced the intricate outlines of the animal shapes, I anxiously awaited and watched for the job to finish. Seeing that the job had completed, it was now time to see how that laser cut everything out. The 40-watt laser cut all my parts with exceptional precision, and they matched my designs perfectly. Now, the last problem I had to solve for was creating the shallow mortises for my fasteners. To accomplish this, I installed the Snapmaker CNC Milling module. My requirement for this project was simple, and yet intricate. I needed to create a few small, precise mortises to insert my fasteners. The CNC module for the Snapmaker seemed to be purposefully designed for just this type of application. I was anxious about this next step because it was the first time I ever used a CNC mill. Feeling confident, I selected my file and clicked the start button. I watched the toolhead cut away at the wood, and it was magic. With each pass, the mortise began to take shape. It was honestly mesmerizing. About halfway through the milling process, I paused the CNC to vacuum out all the dust. After everything was cleaned out, I resumed the milling process and watched the bit cut out the rest of the mortises. When my job finished, I wondered if the CNC had milled out everything as I had designed. I then took everything over to the other side of my shop to cut it out. Now, this was the moment of truth. Could this CNC accomplish what I had instructed it to do? And yes, it fit perfectly. The next step of the project was to create a template for spray painting the eyes. The last time I used the laser, I was pushing its cutting limits. This time, I wanted to test the laser to see if it could cut something a little more delicate, like painter's tape. Through trial and error, I found the right setting to get clean cuts without damaging the tape. I've added the exact settings I used in the description below. The template came out perfectly. I carefully applied the cut template to the head and made sure it adhered smoothly to the surface. I then spray painted the head. I was careful to spray even coats of paint so I wouldn't oversaturate or create streaks on the surface. After allowing the paint to dry, I peeled it off and the result was perfect. The eye had sharp, clean edges and it added just the right amount of personality to the design. With all the parts completed, it was time for the final step, assembling the stool. I decided to share the assembly experience with my son. See, one of the goals from the start was to design a stool that anyone could assemble, and there was no better way to test this than by having my son put it all together. He was really excited to put this stool together because he'd been watching me for the past week or so, designing, engineering, and prototyping all the parts of the stool using the Artisan 3-in-1 machine. Watching him bring the stool to life was a moment of pride and joy. It's one of those moments you recognize your design was a success, but more importantly, you realize these moments are rare, and to be able to share it with your son is priceless. As the final piece went into place, we both stepped back and admired the stool. It now was more than just a functional piece of furniture. It was a creative representation of my manufacturing journey, and in memory with my son, I'll never forget. This journey isn't quite over. If you recall, I started out with a question. Is the Snapmaker Artisan 3-in-1 a gimmick machine that you can't really use? Or is it a professional machine to prototype, manufacture, and sell products at scale? Now, I've always been very skeptical of 3-in-1 machines and their features. However, after using this Artisan 3-in-1 from Snapmaker and testing its capabilities, I honestly don't think my shop can live without it. It has significantly reduced the time and cost of manufacturing prototypes, something that was always really challenging and hard for me to do in the past. It also has allowed me to engineer and assemble my products more efficiently, basically helping me save money on shipping costs, for example. Ultimately, guys, it's empowered me to push my creative boundaries, launch new products, explore and test new ideas, not to mention all the personalization that I now have at my fingertips to offer my customers. And that's something that I never had before. Now, if you're interested in getting this Artisan 3-in-1 by Snapmaker or any of their products, please, I have a discount code for you that you can use to help save you some money in the description below. Now, if you have any questions about this machine or my maker journey, please post them in the comments below as I would love to hear from you and talk to you. Well, that's all I got, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video and I hope to see you in the next one.